Sometimes we would pray to God, and when God does not give us the things we pray for, we get upset, and then we say back to God, "Well, God, did not you say you will give us the desires of our heart?" And you got to be careful of the things you're trying to keep, and you got to be mindful of the stuff that you might have to sometimes throw overboard. Because you understand that desires are not in the spirit of God, but that is a manifestation of the flesh. We always like, when we put God up against anything else, we would rather choose the anything else over God. Why? Because its desires are rooted in the flesh. Why do you think when God then blesses us with the car, that we just told God, "If you bless me with a car, I will not only come to church, but I will pick up folk on my way to church"? But as soon as he blesses you with a car, it fulfills your flesh. So there's no more desire to serve God. You've thrown out all the wrong.
My God.
And we've become so expert at that. You look at the females who say, "Lord, bless me with a good husband." And as soon as God show you a man, because he may be a little short, because he may be growing out this way, I rebuke that. That can't be for me. God know my taste. Well, you throwing out all the wrong stuff, because God know if he give you Monroe, he may be tall, dark, and handsome, but that Negro got a temper.
Amen. Amen. Hallelujah.
So because he want to make sure that you're going to continue to come to church, he's going to give you somebody that when you're getting dressed, who's not going to say, "You go to church again," but they're going to say, "Baby, could you wait a minute, because I want to go with you." Throwing out all the wrong stuff.
Almighty God.
Preach, Pastor.
That can't be God. You see how we look? Well, you got to understand, if you was walking intimately with God, you would understand that God never looks on the outward appearance. Oh my God. But he always searches the heart. And if you're looking at what you see on the outside, you're throwing out all the wrong stuff. Had those mariners the recognition to go down in the bottom of the ship? See, that's another thing with the people of God. We don't like sometimes to make ourselves uncomfortable. Sometimes we don't like to go places that we think, "Oh my God, somebody else should be going."
Do you ever see folk, and I know, don't raise your hand, because I know some of them in here,
who, once you strike title on them, they can't clean bathrooms no more? Had they just walked down at the bottom of the ship, grabbed that sleeping Jonah, and threw him overboard, they would have been in the clear. But they was looking for all the wrong stuff.
They burden with a burden that wasn't even theirs.
It wasn't theirs to deal with, because this tempest that blew was outside of the ordinary. It was orchestrated by God. Watch this. Not to stir up the mariners. Sometimes things go in topsy-turvy in your life. Sometimes things can't come together. God ain't trying to get your attention. He's trying to tell you, watch the people you I trying to get there. And we put ourselves sometimes, you know this whole adage, the whole saying that sometimes the innocent suffer for the guilty. Well, I don't know if I really subscribe to that, because if we say that we serve a God who is a God of justice, I don't know, because the reason I could say that, because when God said to Abraham, "Abraham, I'm about to destroy both Sodom and and Gomorrah. Abraham responded to God and said, are you a God like that, that you would destroy the righteous with the wicked?
I don't believe the innocent suffer with the guilty. I believe the innocent suffer because they throw out all the wrong stuff.
Now we got to recognize, if we're going to make sure, as the saying is, our calling is an election sure, we got to stop allowing folk to rub up on us so we rub up on them and call it friend. Baby, if you were my real friend, when you see me going to church, you'd say, Williams, what's the matter with you? It's been 2 Sundays now. I haven't seen you go to church. You ain't talking about church no more. You ain't going to Bible study. You ain't praying no more. What's the matter? But when you got friends who gonna see you slipping, sliding, and don't